Hello Almighty, today I am going to recap the movie Pirates of the Caribbean on the Stranger Tides. If you like this video, please do subscribe and give me a like. One night off the coast of Spain, a captain and a fisherman discover the body of an ancient sailor in their fishing net. The two examine the dead body until the sailor's eyes open as he grabs the captain's arm. A gold-trimmed carriage races over cobblestones up from a harbor as the old castaway is brought to the royal palace in Cadiz, where he is shown before King Ferdinand. As the sailor gives Ferdinand a logbook, the two fishermen tell of the sailor's stories of having sailed on Ponce de León's ship. Upon seeing an archaic symbol in the logbook, Ferdinand realizes that the sailor's stories, as well as the legends of the Fountain of Youth, were true. Ferdinand then sends his most trusted agent, known only as the Spaniard, to find the fountain. Meanwhile in London, a trial is in session in the Old Bailey against the infamous Captain Jack Sparrow, whom they mistakenly believe Joshamy Gibbs to be. A mysterious Justice Smith appears before the court, Jack Sparrow himself in disguise. Gibbs nearly reveals this in shock of seeing his old captain. Though everyone in the crowd expects a trial, Justice Smith decides an immediate verdict is to be given instead. Gibbs is found guilty of being innocent of being Jack Sparrow and is condemned to life in prison. As Jack takes off his disguise, Gibbs is taken away and put into a horse-drawn paddy wagon. Having paid off the driver, Jack has himself thrown into the paddy wagon with Gibbs. Throughout the ride, Gibbs informs Jack about the rumors of him recruiting a crew for his ship in the Captain's Daughter pub, which intrigues Jack into finding the imposter. The two also briefly talk about Jack's search for the Fountain of Youth, looking at Jack's map. As the carriage suddenly stops, Jack and Gibbs are surprised to find themselves facing down a detachment of royal guards in the courtyard of St. James's Palace. The driver has received a pouch of coins by a guard. Ever hopeful, Gibbs asks Jack if this was part of his plan. However, after the captain of the guards slams Jack's head with a musket, causing Jack to crumple into Gibbs's arms, Jack simply says, "No." Gibbs is then shoved back into the wagon, the door slammed shut, while Jack is dragged into St. James's Palace to meet with King George II. During the first part of the meeting, there is confusion over if Jack is the real Jack Sparrow. Though Jack tries denying it, stating the rumors of him recruiting a crew were false, the king ignores them as they attend to the matter at hand. The king and his ministers ask Jack to guide an expedition to find the Fountain of Youth before the Spanish, in which Jack accepts on the condition of a ship and crew being provided. Jack is then introduced to the captain of the expedition, Hector Barbosa, now a privateer of the crown and now having a peg leg. Upon being asked by Jack of the fate of the Black Pearl, Barbosa reveals that he lost the pearl and his leg in battle. Jack angrily reacts to this revelation, which makes the king's guards restrain him. As Barbosa and the king prepare to continue with their mission, Jack makes one of his legendary escapes, while surrounded by royal guards and a room full of shocked advisors. Despite being outnumbered, Jack is able to escape as the monarch is left stunned. Outwitting the guards, Jack is able to escape the palace and, after robbing a noblewoman, is in a carriage chase through London streets. He is able to escape the king's guards, except for one, who aims his musket right at him. Jack is saved by his father, Captain Teague. At the captain's daughter, having heard that his son was heading to the fountain, Teague informs Jack of the profane ritual, as well as one of the items needed for it, two silver chalices. Although Teague advises Jack against setting sail until he knows every detail, he points Jack to Scrum, sitting with a group of sailor types, saying they have a ship and are signing up sailors. Before leaving, Teague warns Jack that the fountain would test him. Across the room, Scrum finishes and licks on his mandola, until Jack questions him about his recruiting a crew. Scrum corrects him in saying that Jack Sparrow promised a modest venture, before accusing Jack himself being an imposter. This prompts Jack to ask if he knew who he is, which ends with Scrum telling the other volunteered sailors that, here's some bloke what forgot his own name. As they laugh at Jack, Derek bursts out proudly, saying he's sailing with Sparrow, and asking for a drink. Jack steps forward, noticing a silhouette, in the form of Jack Sparrow himself. Sneaking into the storeroom of the captain's daughter, Jack comes face to face with the imposter. The two Jacks draw their swords and engage in a stalemate duel. Jack soon realizes who the imposter is. Dot, his former love, Angelica. The two have a brief reunion with Angelica asking Jack about the Fountain of Youth. Suddenly, the King's guards arrive and engage Jack and Angelica in a fight. Jack and Angelica are able to escape by jumping into the River Thames. As the two go ashore, Jack inquires about the ritual, which Angelica knows about, and what is required. Angelica tells Jack that a mermaid is needed, as her associate drugs Jack with a dart which instantly knocks him out.